They're some of the most vulnerable members of our community, and now a royal commission will expose the treatment faced by people with an intellectual disability in our health system. Today, an inquiry heard the real-life stories of neglect and abuse, which we're told will shock the conscience of all Australians.
Ryan Kelly enjoying summertime with his sister. But in his 8 young years, he's had 50 surgeries. More often than not, it's been a battle for information and the right care.
I've had moments when I felt like he wasn't treated as a human at all. And there's nothing more dehumanising than assuming that someone doesn't even feel pain.
Rebecca, a witness at the start of the Disability Royal Commission in Sydney.
The consequences of neglect or abuse by or within the health system for people with cognitive disability are as disturbing as they are profound. They should shock the conscience of all Australians.
More than 500,000 Australians live with an intellectual disability. Their life expectancy is up to 36 shorter than the general population. Men die on average at 53 years old, while for women the average lifespan is just 49. Kylie Scott, a passionate advocate.
We all need to be understood and supported.
The Commission has received 590 submissions, and at times they've been distressing. One mother was questioned about an end-of-life plan for her son when he presented to the GP with a breathing condition. He was later diagnosed with acid reflux. The hearing will examine barriers to healthcare training and education.
Clearly there are failures in the system, that's undeniable.
Vicky Jardim, Nine News.